And the storm's knocking out power to thousands of homes, businesses, even the Eastlake Police Station. Lightning actually struck an antenna on the building, cutting lines of communication like 911 and radio signals. Our Jennifer Auh has the latest.
Well, the Eastlake Police and Fire Department are right next to each other. The fire chief here telling me that the officers inside heard a loud boom and the whole building was shaking. Meanwhile, the children nearby in the daycare next door were crying in tears after hearing those loud noises.
It was nerve-wracking at first, just we didn't know what happened.
You hear stories of lightning striking the Empire State Building. It happens numerous times a year with the building being so tall. But it's the first time it struck the Eastlake Police Department.
The antenna that was directly hit in thousands of pieces all over the properties.
The lightning striking the antenna of the building, causing an explosion.
They noticed that the rafters and the aluminum parts of the garage actually glowed, and then they saw sparks flying across the front pad.
And across the street from the police and fire department, daycare teacher Brianna Overly showing me what's left of the Agape Land Daycare's playground.
We just try to teach the kids that it's okay, we're going to keep you safe, nothing's going to happen. We were just telling them if the power goes out, we don't need to scream.
And while the teachers were calming the kids down, the police department had to reroute their calls to Willoughby.
We lost our telephones, we lost 911, and we lost our radios that we communicate between each other and other fire departments and police departments.
Thankfully, most of the service lines within the Eastlake Police and Fire Departments are set to go back to normal today. So what should you do if lightning strikes your house or your building? Well, officials say you should call the fire department immediately. Your main concern should be whether a fire was ignited from the lightning strike. In Eastlake, I'm Jennifer Auh, reporting for The Now Cleveland.